Thank you very much. Our next selection is based upon a traditional shaker tune, and it's a very famous piece called The Gift to Be Simple. It's a little variation. We hope you enjoy it. That would not be complete without a beautiful arrangement of Irving Berlin's famous classic song, God Bless America. From West Virginia.
Yes.
We're very proud of that. We are You may have been to Richmond. That's fine. You've been to Virginia then. Yes. We're so happy to be here. We're going to sing a song about our beloved state, written by E.W. James. He was a man with some music background, loved our home state, so he wrote about the state he loved. This is entitled, My Home Among the Hills. Selection, we wanted to pay tribute to those young men who lay buried out there, their gravesite. So we chose the piece, The Lord Bless and Keep You. And if you'll bear with us, we're going to anger ourselves that way out of respect for those individuals who gave all and sing this piece in their memory.
Lord, lift his countenance upon you.
It has been our most humble pleasure to be here today. You can see we're a little emotional. I've talked to the kids a lot about what took place here, obviously well after their lifetime started. And we've studied a lot, and we've learned a lot and discussed a lot, and we've been here all day long. And yeah, it's a little warm, but that's nothing. That's nothing. I told the kids, we can take this because they gave all, and all those who lost their lives here. It has been our distinct honor. We thank you so much for being so gracious to us. And we wanted to end with a beautiful arrangement of America the Beautiful.
Oh.
you right here. Thank you so much.
Oh my goodness, what are they doing?
I think
there's
a Boy Scouts
in there. Scouts. They're going to
do the flag. Did you take
your video? I'm not so young as I used to be.
Well, I'm not either.
You guys sound great, buddy. Thank you. This is Tina Martinez, a former Elizabeth diplomacy.
Properly folding the stars and stripes may look complicated, but it is not. Here is a lesson in the symbolism of folding the flag as described in the U.S. flag folding ceremony. Fold number one. Symbol of life. Fold number two, a symbol of our belief in the eternal life. Fold number three, made in honor and remembrance of the veteran departing our ranks and who gave a portion of life for the defense of our country to attain peace throughout the world. Fold number four, this fold represents our weaker nature. For as American citizens trusting in God, it is to Him we turn in times of peace, as well as in times of war, for His divine guidance. Fold number five, a tribute to our country. For in the words of Stephen DeCotter, our country in dealing with other countries, may she always be right, but it is still our country, right or wrong. Fold number six, this fold stands for where our hearts lie. It is with our heart that we pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Fold number seven, a tribute to our armed forces, for it is through the armed forces that we protected our country and our flag against all enemies, whether they be found within or without the boundaries of our republic. Fold number eight, a tribute to the one who entered the valley of the shadow of death, that we might see the light of day and to honor our mother for whom it flies on Mother's Day. Fold number nine, a tribute to womanhood, for it has been through women's faith, love, loyalty, and devotion that the character of men and women who have made this country great have been molded. Fold number 10, a tribute to Father, for he too has given his sons and daughters for the defense of our country since he or she was first born. Fold number 11, in the eyes of Hebrew citizens, this fold represents the lower portion of the seal of David and King Solomon, and glorifies in their eyes the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Fold number 12. In the eyes of the Christian citizens, this fold represents the emblem of eternity and glorifies in their eyes God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. When the flag is folded completely, the stars are uppermost, reminding us our national motto, In God We Trust. After the flag is folded completely and tucked in, it takes on the appearance of a cocked hat. This reminds us of the soldiers who served under General George Washington and the sailors and the Marines who served under Captain John Paul Jones, who were followed by their comrades and shipmates in the armed forces of the United States, preserving for us the rights, privileges, and freedoms that we enjoy today.
We cry. Sorry.
Well, here's what we're going to do. You now have time to. We now don't have time to.